So this is lecture 39th on series compensation using dynamic voltage restorer. So last time we have studied that how to find out the DVR voltage based on the requirement of the compensation. And if you recall that we have developed this equation for computation of the DVR voltage BF or BDVR as a function of the parameters A2, A1, B1, B2 and B source square. Here K is for ABC. For three phase system, the K may vary from ABC. So what we have discussed for actually single phase system. So here K, ABC, this equation. So what we have developed was this BF square minus 2 A1 A2 dash plus B1 B2 dash into BL and then BFK. BL is missing here, so add it here, BL into BF plus A2 dash square plus B2 dash square minus BS square equal to 0. This equation was on the single phase basis. Now if we add K, then it becomes for three phase where K is equal to ABC. We can solve for each phase. So you can add K here, then K means ABC. So this is K, here K, K and K. That's how we get this equation. So today we will take one example to explain the concept and then we will go further to understand the transient operation of the DVR. So this example 6.2 in the book is given here. The voltage that is given to us is 230 volt, which is 1.0 per unit at 50 hertz frequency as shown here, and it is supplying the load which consists of 0.5 plus say 0.3 per unit impedance here through the feeder impedance ZS, which is 0.05 plus J0.3. This is the feeder impedance. We have to add DVR here to maintain the voltage PL. So find the value of the DVR voltage. And there are other questions as well. First is compute the load voltage without DVR. Second, compute the DVR voltage such that VL is equal to VS. That is the magnitude of load voltage is same as the magnitude of the source voltage. And then compute the effective source voltage including the DVR and explain the power flow in the circuit. And the D part is compute the terminal voltage BT with DVR compensation, this one. So it looks like circuit is very small, but it has lots of details. And these parameters have to be understood from the perspective of the voltage compensation. So let's take the first part, the DVR voltage, the voltage at the load bus without DVR. So when DVR is not connected, the current that flows in the circuit is given by IL, which is same as I equal to BS, the overall source here, BS. This is BS divided by ZL plus ZS or ZS plus ZL. So supply voltage divided by total impedance. Now we have taken reference voltage for supply is 1.0 angle of 0 and this is ZS plus ZL 0.55 plus J0.6. This is summation of this and this. Okay, and this becomes 1.22 or 1.23 angle of minus 47. So this current flows in the circuit without any compensation. So what is the voltage at the load bus? The voltage at the load bus will be either Zs into Is, ZL into Is, or it can also be equal to Bs minus speed drop Is into Zs, which is also equal to BL into ZL. So we can compute using any of these equations. The answer is 0.7164 angle of minus 16. So two things you observe. Number one, the magnitude of the load voltage has reduced from 1.0 to 0.7. So there is a reduction of almost 30%. The voltage at the load bus must be actually 1.0, but it is basically 0.71. So there is a 30% reduction in the voltage. If the loads connected to this bus are sensitive, they will not operate at this voltage, they will malfunction. Okay, so we have to now use the DVR to make it 1.0 per unit. So this has to go as 1.0 some angle, whatever you call it, let us say delta VL. So to solve this, we connect the DVR. So in B part, the DVR is connected, and let the DVR voltage be BF. So this BF is in phasor form, and this BF is in its time domain form. So actually we have to compute this BF, angle of BF. Okay, this has to be computed. So if we find the BF phasor, we can also construct the time domain of the DVR voltage. Let us start. So if we desire to maintain BL equal to BS, this condition, then we have to solve for the current first. So let BL be 1.0 angle of 0. This is BL. This is new value of BL. This is the desired value of load voltage. And let it be reference phasor, because this is my point of reference, so I will lock all the quantities to this reference phasor. So this is BL divided by ZL. The term in the denominator is ZL. So BL by ZL becomes 1.715 angle of minus 30. This is the actually healthy current that is supposed to flow in the load, because the voltage is healthy and therefore the current is the one which is being required by the load. Now once I know the current I, then we will compute the angle of BF. Okay, the angle of BF is nothing but angle of current I plus 90 degree. It could be minus 90 also, it depends upon what polarity you take in the beginning. Since we have taken source polarity minus plus, okay, so because of this source, here we have taken plus 90. If you treat this BF as a load, then the polarity will change and hence it become minus of this. So that will lead to I angle of actually minus 90 degree. So that is our choice. Whatever we want, we can take it. But for that given polarity, this is the more natural choice. Even if you take minus 90, at the end of calculation, you will get the negative result. So you can correct that. All right, so we have this current. Now we write the equation for voltage in the circuit So BS plus BF is equal to BL plus RS plus JXS into IE. Okay, this is standard equation for the circuit, DVR circuit or DVR compensated circuit. Then the DVR voltage is given as BF equal to BF magnitude and angle of BF, which is IS plus 90 degree, the same thing as here. Okay, so angle comes from the angle of current plus 90 degree. Alright, so what is this? Angle of IS plus 90 degree, angle of IS is minus 30 here, and therefore minus 30.96 plus 90 degree becomes 59.04. So BF phasor equal to VF angle of 59.04. So the VF phasor here equals to VF angle of 59.04. So this is actually A1 plus JB1, because we have defined earlier that VF angle is nothing but A1 plus JB1 in the equation. So therefore A1 is nothing but cosine of that angle plus J sine of that angle, and therefore A1 is cos 59.04 here and B1 is 0.86. So we know A1 and B1, and A2 and B2 are found from the drop across the feeder, which is RS plus JXS into I. So RS plus JXS we know, I we also know. We simplify this expression and we get that the value of this drop across the feeder is 0.3370 plus J0.3956, which is nothing but A2 plus JB2. That's how we define A2 and B2 parameters. So A2 is 0.337 and B2 is 0.3958. Clear? So we know A1, B1, A2, B2. And then we can use the previous equation, that is BF square, quadratic equation in BF, that is BF square minus 2. This is A2 dash, which is 1 plus A2 into A1 plus B1 B2 into BF. BL is missing here, so you have to add BL here, which is 1.0. Theoretically, BL has to come here. So this is BL plus 1 plus A2 square, or you can say A2 dash square. This is plus B2 square. And this is minus BH square, which is also 1.0 equal to 0. Because BS is 1.0 RMS value, and BL is also 1.0. Okay, so here the BS and BL are taken as 1.0, and if we simplify this expression, we get the equation VF square minus 2.04 63 VF plus 0.92442 equal to 0. If we solve this quadratic equation, we get two solutions for this corresponding to the two intersections on the circle in the graphical representation. And these two points are 0.7028 and 1.3434 per unit. So there are two values. Which value we will choose? We will choose the one which is having less value of BF, because it is easy to realize. It is a small value, so it can be easily realized as compared to the higher value. So we prefer, this is the feasible solution, 0.7028, and therefore this is the magnitude of BF, that is 0.7028, and angle we already know, that is 59.04. therefore this is BF phasor. Now once I know the BF phasor, then we can write that BFT as a function of time is root 2 into RMS value of this 0.7028 sine omega T plus 59.04 degree. This is the time domain expression for BF. In this part, you can also compute the source voltage, BS. But you may say that we already know what is BS. You say that we, in the beginning, we have taken BS as 1.0 equal to BL. So why we need to compute BS? We need to compute BS because we do not know the phase angle of BS. Okay? We have substituted the magnitude of BS as 1.0, but we have no idea that what is the phase angle of BS. So to know the phase angle, we must have to solve for it, and therefore we use the same equation, that BS equal to BL plus RS plus JXS into I minus BF. So we know BF here, and we know all these parameters, substitute them, we'll get 1.0. So this magnitude must match with this value. If all computation is fine, then we must get 1.0. That ensures that the calculations we made are correct. And angle is minus 11.89. So you see, BS is 1.0, angle of minus 11.89 degree per unit, and BL is 1.0, angle of 0. Now looking these two values, you feel that how the power can flow from BS to BL, because BS has a negative angle. Okay, if you know the power system, this is the load, this is the source, this is the load here, this is a transmission line. So this is actually BL, this is BS. To make power flow from BS to BL, BS must lead the BL. You know the expression B1 or BS BL into sine delta by X, if the line is purely reactive. Delta is angle between the BS and BL. So delta is positive if the power has to flow from this to this. So don't get confused with this negative angle, because the effective source is another interesting term. The effective source actually is BS plus BF, because there is a addition of the DVR voltage. So if you look from the source point of view, the effective voltage is BS dash, and this BS dash is equal to BS plus BF. If we calculate this value, then we will find that this value comes out to be as 1.3958, angle of 16.52. See the angle and see the magnitude. Okay, the magnitude is greater than 1 and angle is also positive. So that will still ensure that power is flowing from the source to the load. Okay, so from this negative angle, we should not be confused, because we have to see in total, and the total supply voltage seen from the source side is basically 1.39, angle of 16.52. That again ensures that our calculation is correct and power flowing is in the right direction. Now this you can look in the form of the whole circuit aspect. So BL is 1.0, after compensation. This is after compensation, is supplying the load satisfactorily, and the current is 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 equal to IL. This is RS, Z axis, and BS dash is basically 1.39 angle of 16.52. So this angle is 0, this angle is 16.52, therefore power flow happens from source to the load. B may also calculate the terminal voltage. The terminal voltage is BT, and BT will be BS minus ZS into IS or ZS into I. You know, this is the voltage BS here, then we have source bus, then we have feeder impedance, and then we have a BT here. So this is BT, this is BS, then we have a DVR here, minus plus, and then we have a BL here. After BL we have a load, okay. So this BT is here. So what is BT? This voltage minus this drop. Current is I, suppose. So BS on the phasor basis, it will be BS minus RS plus JXS into IS. Same thing is here. This is also equal to BL minus BF. If you calculate from this side, okay, then if you start from here, this is voltage rise. So this is minus BF. So this is minus BF. This is voltage drop. This is BL. Okay, so this BT can be solved either using BS minus ZS into I or BL minus BF. Both expressions can be used. The answer is 0.8796 angle of minus 43. Again, do not get confused by this negative sign. You may be thinking that the how power can flow from BT to BL if this is negative sign. Okay, so this is a local phenomena. If you see the supply voltage in total, it is again positive. Okay, so this is the example 6.10, and based on that there are many more questions at the end of the book. Go through them, solve them, answers are given, and verify your answers. Now the next part of this DVR unit is the transient operation of the DVR. So till now what we have been discussing was about the steady state computation. In the transient operation, the following steps are followed. Number one, define the reference quantity here, because you have to define the reference phasor or reference quantity. It can be load voltage or any other variable in other phasor. So mostly it is the load voltage. So BL is defined as the reference quantity. Therefore, BL is equal to BL angle of 0. And then synchronize all other quantities to it. So all other quantities, that is IL, BS, BT, all are locked to this phasor, or this is a reference phasor. The next step is to compute the angle of DVR voltage. The angle of DVR voltage, that is BF. And how shall we compute BF? Angle of BF must be 90 degree to IS. Why 90 degree? So that it does not change the real power flow in the circuit. It only consumes the reactive power. Okay, so therefore the angle of BF is equal to angle of IS plus 90 degree. Third point, after knowing the angle of BF, we compute the magnitude of BF by solving this equation, the quadratic in BF voltage. So this subroutine has to be called to solve for BF. And once we know the BF magnitude, RMS value, and the phase angle, then we construct the time domain expression for the BF and realize this voltage using the power circuit. So this is infinite loop. It keeps on doing depending upon the detection of the voltage sag or any other abnormal voltage conditions. So these steps are followed to implement the real-time implementation of the DVR. This scheme which we have just described can be called as control scheme of type 1. Type 1 control. Which control scheme? This scheme. What this scheme involves? It involves solving the VF depending upon A1, A2 dash, B1, B2 dash, and then BS as well as BL. So BL I have taken 1.0, but BL has to be here. Correct? So information actually A2, B2, if you look carefully, information about BS, information about A2, B2, then information about A1 and B1. What are these parameters? BS actually is information about the source voltage or the voltage upstream side. A2, B2 are the drop across the feeder, so they require the information about RS and XS. And A1, B1 are the angle of the, concerned to the angle of the VF. So basically we need the information about the feeder impedance and the source to implement this equation. So in type 1 control, we need the impedance parameter, the source feeder impedance parameters and the source voltage information. But sometimes it is not possible to have this information. So in that case, how to implement this algorithm? In that case, we have to look for the local variables. BS and RS and XS are not the local variables, they are far away variables, because the feeder impedance is start from the source voltage to the load voltage. Okay, so they are not available at the local point, at the local bus. So this type of control can be called as type 2 control. So type 2 control is the one which depends upon the local variables. It does not depend upon the BS and A2 and V2. What is the trick? The trick is that we measure the voltage, terminal voltage. We don't measure the voltage BS. Okay? So we do not measure the voltage BS. It's not measured, because it is not a local variable. Rather, we just measure the VT. Where is the VT? VT is just here. If I draw the diagram, this is the BS, then this is the feeder impedance, this is VT here, this is BS here, then this is TVR, VF, and this is VL here, and then there is a load. So we will measure this voltage which is just near the DVR. So this is the local point for the DVR or the load. So we will measure only VT. So let us say we measure VT. Then BT equal to BL plus BF, because if you see from this side, BL minus BF, not plus BF, because BT plus BF equal to BL. So this is minus sign, not plus sign. Okay, correct this. Okay, we apply Kirchhoff voltage here. So BT plus BF becomes BL, therefore BT becomes BL minus BF. So BT becomes BL minus BF here. Okay. Now we again expand these values of BL and BF, then you can see that let BT be angle of bt and angle of delta t, or delta bt you can say, delta t terminal voltage angle equal to BL angle of 0, let us take as a reference phasor, minus BF angle of BF, which is A1 plus JB1. Then we collect the real and imaginary part of this equation. And you can see from here that this is the real part, BL minus A1 BF, and minus JB1 into VF is the imaginary part. And this side, we can also write the real part and the imaginary part. If we square and add these, the real imaginary parts, on the left hand side, we will get BT square. And the right hand side will get BL minus A1 BF square plus B1 BF square. So this becomes BL square plus A1 square BF square minus 2A1 BF BL plus B1 square BF square. So as we know that A1 square plus B1 square is 1. Therefore, this together becomes BF square here minus 2A1 BL into BF plus BL square minus BT square equal to 0. This equation is the equation that is based on type 2 control. What it needs? It needs only A1 information and the terminal voltage information. So this BT it needs, BL already defined, for that we have to compute BF, and we need A1, not even B1, A1 is enough. So this equation is more simplified and depends upon the local variable, that is the A1. It does not need any information of A2 and B2 and BS. And this type of control is referred as the type 2 control. And once we know VF and the angle of VF, we can construct BFT as a function of time, which is equal to root 2 into BF into sine omega t plus angle of BF. And once we know this time domain expression, we can realize it by the power circuit. Now you can ask the question, what if the BL is not the reference phasor? As we have done in the previous case also, that it need not to be a reference phasor. So if it is not a reference phasor, then we will express like this. Let BL be, BL phasor is equal to BL magnitude and angle of delta L. Delta L is the angle of this voltage compared to or with reference to some reference phasor. Okay, so this will be equal to BL cos delta L plus just BL sin delta L. So we just simply substitute value of this BL in the original equation here, in this equation. So BT delta T becomes, you can say the delta T if you want to be more clear, equal to BL cos delta L minus A1 BF. The real part has come here together and the imaginary part has come together here. So there are four terms, two for real and two for the imaginary. Okay, then we square these terms. And then we found, simplify them. Okay. Then BL square cos delta L and BL square sin delta L will become BL square here, and A1 square BF square and B1 square BF square becomes BF square here. The remaining we collect together, so minus 2 is common, A1 cos delta L plus B1 sin delta L into BL BF plus BL square minus BF square. Now this need information about A1 cos delta L plus B1 sin delta L. So B1 is required here. In previous case B1 was not required because the BL was a reference phasor. If BL is not a reference phasor, then we need A1 and B1 both. So whole thing we can call as A1 dash. Then this equation becomes similar to this equation where we write Vf square minus 2A1 dash into BL into Vf plus BL square minus BT square. So this is the type 2 control where BL is not the reference phasor. So this and this equation are similar except A1 dash is now this value. Clear? Alright, then the same concept can be implemented for operation of the three-phase DVR with unbalanced voltage, without harmonics and with harmonics. Let us take the first case where we consider the operation of three-phase DVR with unbalanced voltage without harmonics. So they are fundamental unbalance in the supply voltage and we want to compensate for it. Okay, so first we will define that what kind of voltage we want at the load. So we define that BLA, what is BLA, what is BLB and what is BLC. Of course they are balanced and sinusoidal. So we define like root 2B, you can say sine omega t for reference phasor. This is root 2B sine omega t minus 120 degree and this is root 2B sine omega t plus 120 degree. Okay, so these are three phase desired voltage at the load bus. Once we know these voltages, we define this voltage, we can find out the current IA, IB, IC. And from these currents, we can find out the angle for VFA, VFB and VFC. So we know IA, IB, IC, then IA plus 90 becomes VFA, IB plus 90 becomes VFB and IC plus 90 becomes VFC. So we know the angles of DVR voltages, which is nothing but AA1 plus JBA1, A phase, so A1 means basically, or simply A, you can say AA plus BA, one is not required. Okay, so one is not required. Then we can write this is nothing but AB plus JBB and this is AC plus JBC. So we have now A1 and B1 parameters. So actually A1 we have to use for A2 and A1. So one has to be here. So this is 1A, 1B, then 1C and 1C. And once we know these phase angles, then we can solve the quadratic equation to find out the magnitude VFA, VFB, VFC. And once we know VFA, VFB, VFC, we can find out the time domain expressions for these voltages. Okay, so it is just the extension of the single phase implementation of DVR. Only the calculation is three times. For each phase, we have to calculate the angle and the quadratic equation and then we construct the time domain expression for the DVR voltage. The same thing is true for the three phase voltage with harmonics, unbalanced voltage with harmonics. Okay, so this is three phase unbalanced voltages with harmonics. So in case of harmonics, we have to separate the fundamental and harmonics. So what shall we do? We will run the fundamental extraction program or algorithm to generate BTA1. So BTA equal to BTA1 plus BTAH, harmonic remaining harmonics, or BTB equal to VTB1 plus BTBH, H for harmonic terms, and VTC equal to VTC1 plus VTC1. CH. What is 1 here? It is the fundamental of terminal voltage for phase A, B and C. So this is one step. Second step is to compute the current and to find the angle of VFA1, VFB1, VFC1. They are the fundamental voltages for DBR. So for a given load voltages, you got it? For given load voltages, let us say BLA, BLB and BLC, we compute the currents. So these lead to the currents IA, IB, IC. Since they are having harmonics, so better to talk in terms of the time domain because it involves various frequencies. This could be at one frequency. So I would say BLA, BLB, BLC, each voltage leads to IA, IB, IC. From this IA, IB, IC, again we compute ILA1, fundamental of this current, ILB1 and ILC1. And then we find the angles. So IA1 is here, IA1 plus 90 becomes BFA1, IB1 plus 90 becomes BFB1, and IC1 plus 90 becomes BFC1. So now we have angles of the fundamental DBR voltages. And once we know these angles, we can compute the magnitude of these fundamental DBR voltages by using the type 2 control equation, BFA1 square, see the term, BFA1 minus 2A1 into BL into BFA1 plus BL square minus BTA1 square. So whole equation holds for the fundamental voltage. And using this equation, we solve for BFA1. So this will give you BFA1. Once I know this magnitude and this angle, then we can reconstruct VFA1 in time domain. This is the magnitude, this is the phase angle. So this is VFA1, this is VFB1, this is VFC1. Okay, this is fine because this is fundamental. What about harmonics? So harmonics of the DBR voltage will be negative of the terminal voltage because they have to nullify the harmonics present at the terminal point. As I said, that BTA, in the beginning I said, what is BTA? BTA is nothing but VTA 1 plus VTA harmonic. So this is the harmonic component of the terminal voltage. This has to be nullified. Therefore, we add the negative of this to the DBR voltage. So BFAH, the harmonic component of the DBR for phase A will be minus BTAH, and BFVH is minus BTBH, and BFCH is equal to minus BTCH. And once we know this harmonic component, then we add with the fundamental. So VFA1 plus BFAH becomes BFA, and BFB1 plus BFBH becomes BFB, and BFC1 plus BFCH becomes BFC. So these are the final expressions for the DBR voltages, and once we know these in time domain values or time domain ream, then we can implement them into the real time domain expressions using the power circuit. Okay, so once these values are known in a time domain, then we can implement by realizing them using the converter. So in the next class, I will discuss that how to use the converter, what is the converter configurations, and how we can realize these extracted value of the reference DBR voltages, VFA, VFB, VFC.